Hello everyone, today I am going to teach you chromosomal disorders mnemonic. Okay. The first I will be teaching in pairs of chromosome, like two diseases with chromosome abnormalities. So first group is neuroblastoma and nephroblastoma. Neuroblastoma is chromosome 1 and nephroblastoma is chromosome 11 or 2 ones, because one, the word one contains NE and neuro and nephroblastoma starts with NE. And the confusing part will be which is chromosome 1, if neuroblastoma is 1 or nephroblastoma is 1. So we have one brain, so chromosome 1 is neuroblastoma, and we have two kidneys, so chromosome 11 is nephroblastoma. The next group is BRCA1 and BRCA2. Here you have to remember this 17 and 13. So I'll tell you how not to confuse between 1 and 2. So BRCA2 is chromosome 13, because 1 minus 3 is equal to 2. And if it is 13, so BRCA1 should obviously be 17. The next group is neurofibromatosis 2 and neurofibromatosis 1. 2 is simple, chromosome 22. And then 1, neurofibromatosis 1 is also known as von Recklinghausen disease. So if you count the number of letters in von Recklinghausen, it is 17 letters. So it is chromosome 17. And the next group is RH, ABO and HLA. RH is the only two letter word in the entire chromosomal disease. So we'll give it number 1, so chromosome 1. Then ABO is a 3 letter word, so 3 square is chromosome 9. And HLA, H is for hexa, which means 6. So HLA is chromosome 6. Remember, in glycogen storage diseases, Tay-Sachs is for 6, so it is hexosaminidase. So wherever H, it will be 6. The next group is this trinucleotide repeats, Huntington's and Friedreich's ataxia. So Huntington is chromosome 4, because H can be written as 4, so chromosome 4. How I remembered was, I was a very good fan of Dr. House MD, in that we had a character called 13 who had Huntington's disease. So 1 plus 3 is 4, and H you can rewrite as 4, so you can remember it that way. And the Friedreich's ataxia is chromosome 9, because Friedreich's, the word, is 9 letters. So it is chromosome 9. Since we are into this trinucleotide repeats, I will tell the mnemonic for that also. So there are 4 diseases. In this, the first 3, fragile X, Huntington's and myotonic, are a group. And Friedreich's ataxia is separate, because it's the only one which starts with G and ends with A. The other 3 starts with C and ends with G. Okay. So in the word Friedreich's, you can add a letter N, it will become friend. So you can remember girlfriend, my girlfriend, rich ataxia. So GAA is Friedreich's ataxia. And the other 3 diseases are simple. They all start with C and end with G. And fragile X, the middle letter is G, so it is CGG. And myotonic dystrophy, the middle letter is T, so it is CTG. Huntington's, it sounds like A, so it is CAG, CAG. And Down syndrome, I don't have to tell, it's trisomy 21, you all know that. Edwards syndrome is trisomy 18, because Edwards E and 18 starts with E. And the next one is Patau syndrome is trisomy 13. If you count Patau syndrome, it becomes 13 letters. So it is trisomy 13. So these are the 3 trisomies you have to remember. And one more we have is Kreiduchat syndrome. It's also known as 5P minus syndrome. Kreiduchat is basically cat cry syndrome. So cat, you can say it as pussy in English. And pussy is 5 letters. So it is 5. And pussy starts with P. So it is 5P deletion. Okay. And the next one is VHL von Hippel-Lindau. It's a 3 letters, so it is chromosome 3. And familial adenomatous polyposis, FAP, starts with F, F for 5, so it is 5. Since we have already had 5P for Kreiduchat, so it is 5Q. Now next one is hemochromatosis. Since I told you H, anything H is hexa, which is 6. Now next one is cystic fibrosis. Fibrosis is a 7-letter word, so it is chromosome 7. Now next one is Burkitt's lymphoma. Burkitt's B looks like 8, so it is chromosome 8. And the last is chromosome is chromosome 13, which is Wilson's disease and retinoblastoma. Wilson, the first two letters W and I can be rewritten as 1-3. And again, retinoblastoma, the letter R can be split into 1 and 3. So it is chromosome 13. Thank you, friends. If you do like the video, please comment and then subscribe to the YouTube channel Medical Maniacs to not miss out such videos.